Okay, Dave McPartland, it's a bloody terrible day out there as we're about to hit stage 10, but we've also got the terrible news about Callum, so just tell us.
Callum was sick. We isolated him yesterday and then did a test this morning and it was positive, so fortunately that's the end of his Giro. He was already off a little bit in the time trial the other day, and then yesterday wasn't feeling good at all. Did a test yesterday and was negative, and this morning still had same symptoms, and tested him again and was positive. So that explains why he was off the other day in the time trial.
Yeah, a real shame because he's such a vital part of that, not just a lead-out train for Bling, but he's been climbing so well to pull things back together. So he's going to be sorely missed.
Yeah, perhaps even more so in the mountains. He's trimmed down the last couple of years and he's proven really reliable for us. And he was going to be, you know, our last man in the mountains. Yeah, but anyway, the game goes on, the race goes on, and Zana's has certainly impressed so far in this Giro. So, you know, it's about taking opportunities in other areas as well, and supporting Eddie as best as we can. As I say, Filippo will take over Callum's role there in the mountains in the big final week.
All right, good luck today, mate.
Thank you.
G'day, buddy. Well, look, terrible day out there and just bad news about Callum. We're gonna miss him over the next week and a half.
Yeah, I mean, it was really unfortunate because he was super strong. He was in unreal form. So, yeah, I guess it's how it goes at the moment. And he'll head home and he'll come back strong for the next one.
Now, you were a little bit unwell yourself a couple of days ago, but you seem to have bounced back okay.
Yeah, I mean, definitely a little bit of lingering here going on still, but in general, yeah, had a few gut issues and, yeah, struggled to process a bit of food, but we'll keep on pushing.
So what's going to happen today, mate?
Oh, I mean, hopefully we can get Bling up for a good ride. I mean, yeah, it'll be hard in the wet. It's pouring down with rain, but I think it might be a reduced bunch sprint today.
Okay, good luck, partner.
Thank you.
So there's one rider from each team meeting with the officials to make a decision on whether this stage actually starts because of the terrible winds and conditions up on the climb. So that decision is about to be made and we'll know shortly.
Yes, but I guess we have to think. When there's COVID a bit everywhere, we talk about that. Staying healthy is the main word.
Yeah, indeed. I mean, it's a long way to Rome, and the only way to get there is to remain healthy. And unfortunately, there's a lot of guys, not starting, especially after rest day. Maybe people are testing and whatnot, but yeah, hopefully the peloton stays healthy and can continue racing.
Not an easy stage to read again, especially with the weather. What do you think?
No, I agree. I mean, it's a really tough stage. The first half of the stage, majority climbing. It really depends on the climbers and the GC teams whether they let the sprinters control. So we'll find out pretty shortly, and hopefully we have a sprint today.
And the main GC team being in EOS, knowing how they ride usually, it's rather good for the sprinters, no?
I mean, I expect that everyone will let us race. I mean, there's three sort of maybe sprint stages coming up and then a really hard final week as well, so I think the climbers will have their fix in the end of the race.
Just one last thing, how is the body reacting after almost 10 days of race?
Yeah, I mean, it's pretty good. Had a nice rest day, feeling well. I think the peloton will be getting a bit smaller with some guys like I said being sick, but for me it's all going pretty well.
Thank you, Callum.
Morning, Jay. Another day in paradise.
Yep. Wonderful weather out here today.
I think the riders just had a meeting with the organisers. What was the result of that?
I have no idea. I haven't had a chance to talk to anyone yet.
Okay. Talking about maybe changing some things. So it's been a pretty solid first week of Giro.
Yep.
You've had some bad luck, but you're still right in the mix. How are you feeling yourself?
Yeah, fine. I think everyone in the peloton's a bit sick, but... we've got a couple of easier days and we'll see if anyone's really motivated to make today hard, but we'll see what happens.
It doesn't look too easy today, but I know what you mean. There probably will be a sprint day, although the brakes have been
successful in recent stages?
Yeah, I mean, it'll be up to only a couple of teams to control today, but we'll see what happens, because it's a lot of energy to control, and if a group of 10 guys go up the road, they're all really motivated, it'll definitely go all the way to finish.
Now, sometimes after a rest day, the legs are a little bit heavy, and other times you feel $1 million. What is it for you?
Well, I've literally done about 12 pedal strokes, so I've got no idea how the legs are today. I've basically looked at the courses and gone, look, there's not going to be too much GC action over the next couple of days, so I can take a really easy day yesterday.
It's interesting, there's been a fantastic Giro, and now we've got the situation, of course, with Remco being out, it changes the ball game quite a lot. But we've got, of course, Ineos with their double prong, and there's probably three teams who've got that, yourselves, the UAE, with you and JO, and also Bora a bit, they've got two GC riders. So that's going to be a card you can play down the track.
Yeah, I think so. We'll have to see what happens on the road, but yeah, I think the final week is where we'll see those cards being played, that's for sure.
Good luck, mate.
All right, thank you.
It's obviously just going to be different having the jersey in the team, basically, rather than chasing it. So, I think try to enjoy today as much as I can, but try and stay warm and as dry as possible, and we'll see what we can do.
Being home in Wales, isn't it?
It is, yeah. I haven't been back much. I left there because of the weather. So, but no, it should be all right.
Good luck today.
Enjoy your first
day
in pink.
Thank you.
Thanks. You're looking very good in pink.
It's a bit weird to be in pink, I think.
Yeah, luckily it stopped raining for now, so might be able to have it out for a bit. But just try and keep warm, because it's going to be a hard day.
Yesterday you've got one day to change your mind about the tactics. It went okay?
Yeah, obviously it's a completely different race for us now this week. Well, not completely different, but definitely different approach. And but it's always a boost to get a jersey in the team. It's a massive honour for myself. First time to wear the pink jersey. So, looking forward to it.
Another day at Giro.
So, I see the riders had a meeting then with the organisers. What was the result of that?
To be honest, we had a meeting all together as the riders, and then RCS or the Giro organisers arrived. And there was a lot of discussion, some of it in Italian, and finally I need to actually leave and go to the bus to get ready for sign on, and I'm not sure what was decided.
But it looks like you're racing.
But we always wanted to race. It wasn't whether we were going to race or not to race. It was just that we wanted to change the course a little bit and do the final part of the course after the long downhill, because finally we arrived to 1,500 meters today. And okay, the weather right now, it's raining and it's not too bad, but I think at 1,500 meters, it can be also not super nice for us.
So how are you? How have you come out of the rest day? How are the legs?
I'll tell you this afternoon.
It's been a pretty solid week. You've been a fraction further back than you would like to be, but still a lot of bike race to happen.
No, exactly. It's a super hard Giro to come, and we just keep chipping away and hope for some good luck, and you never know what'll happen.
Good luck, mate.
Cheers. Thanks, guys.